Stage 11, Rock Springs, Wyoming, to Twin Falls, Idaho. The cars traverse across the final miles of the Great Plains, through valleys carved by glaciers and streams. Leaving Wyoming and crossing into Idaho. The cars get stopped along the way by road construction and come streaming into Montpelier, Idaho for the morning pit stop. Once back on the road, they quickly encounter a maze, crossing through unregulated intersections. If they're not careful, this could end up more like a demolition derby. The racers pass a checkpoint just after the maze, making it difficult to make up for any mistakes they made inside the maze. The lunch stop was in Pocatello, Idaho, and a large crowd watched the cars pull in. And Native Americans with an authentic display of dance and a look back into their proud history. After lunch, the route takes the cars across the sparsely populated prairies, where vast herds of buffalo once roamed free. The spare tire on the 1911 Vealey H1 driven by Howard Sharp rattles loose, and Doug Sharp must perform the great race version of a spacewalk. He climbs out onto the trunk of the car and secures the tire while they're still moving. Other racers have missed speed chains and markers and become bunched up. And others are unsure if they're even on the right road. They continue on and make it to the afternoon pit stop in Rupert, Idaho. Sam Hanegriff, also known as Tiny Elvis, signs autographs. After a cold glass of lemonade, it's off to the finish line in Twin Falls, Idaho. Twin Falls was the winner of the Best Overnight Stop Award.
Brendan Silvey!
115!
Wow, 115! All right, getting those times down there. Making on through three old cars since 1954.
What a great time! 34 blocks passed. Let's see how they did.
258! 258! The 2004 champions from Cincinnati, Arkansas! Germantown, Tennessee,
right there.
The 2004 champions, G.R. Pike, Bobby Hatsky, they nailed 9 seconds.
And there's the leader right there.
Curly, there they come.
19 seconds.
Rock it on in. Wow, 19 seconds, simply wow.
And they got
Thirsty.
An ace.
And an ace.
11 Charlie seconds.
On 11 seconds today.
Great job, guys.
On the fourth piece for 11 seconds.
Second.
Kelly Crawford, Tom Williamson. Clem Lang deserves
the 1920 Essex.
The 20 Essex, 15 seconds.
15, 7 seconds. 7 seconds right there. Second place.
7
so
seconds
far.
Today. Fairport, New
10
York.
10 seconds.
10 seconds in the old village.
All right, that puts you in about fifth place, but you're doing great.
Seconds and one ace for Rock Wilson.
That puts you in third place.
Peter Dunner. 54 seconds for Ponca City. Here we go. Team 101, Explorer Post 69. Welcome from Tacoma, Washington, Doug LeMay, John Keel out of Mertzown, Pennsylvania. Hey, you nailed the ace today. The spirit of America. And you nailed
20 seconds.
And
great job.
Ace as well. Dennis Barfield, Bill Schaefer, 1928 Ford, Model A Band, and that's top team. Wow. Look at the time. I love watching this Ford Thunderbird come in every night. It makes me think of my wife, who I haven't seen in a long, long time, it seems. This young couple is married 58 years. He stops and tells her he's home safely every night at the finish line. Seconds! That'll put you in second place today. Great job!
Actually, it comes out of a collection of kids. Yeah, this is a poster. These are our cars here. The 30.
Here are the results for Stage 11. In first place, it's Len John Vanderwill and David Dingman in their 1934 Ford Indy Racer. The Ford Model A Woody, driven by Darby Cole, finishes second. Third place goes to Fredette Jackson, Steve and Edward Torgi in fourth, and Cunningham and Geppinger in fifth. Their consistently strong scores keep them in first place, with Wilson and Dunn in second and Levine and Wheeler in third.